Hey guys, welcome back to the Travis Heath Racing Channel. Today we're continuing working on the S13. We are going to be focusing on the interior. We are still in disassembly mode. There is a lot in here that I want to dress up, clean up, fix, alter, all of the above. I have a long list, some of those including fixing the notorious 240 dash crack, which just makes your car look like trash. So I want to get that. That'll be its own separate video or even a couple, but I want to get that fixed, recovered, all of the above. So it's looking nice, fine. Clean up these cuts a little bit around the cage. I also will probably be doing a completely stock one that's not cut for a cage. Since I'm here and doing it, might as well. So if you want to stick around to check out for that. And so we're going to be doing some wiring in here. I want to do clean up the wiring, make it a little bit more plug and play, easy to disconnect, service, stuff like that. The seats will be coming out. I want to get the inside freshened up, repainted, do something down here for the floor, on at least on the driver's side. It's super slippery when it's wet and or just feels like there's no traction down there. All in all, that's pretty much what I'm going to be doing. Finally get these doors painted. This has bugged me ever since I painted the interior of this car, that they're not painted, so I want to get that done. Enough talking. I know I'm always talking, but just thought I'd give you a little overview of what we're going to do today. I'll bring you along with me. Let's get it done. So something that has been on my heart lately, I've been thinking about mulling over, and it's kind of cool. Went to church today. Now, if I said church and that freaks you out, you may not be a Christian. That's okay. We welcome everybody in on the Travis Heath Racing Channel. If you don't believe in God, if you are not a Christian, if you're an atheist, that's okay with me. I'm a Christian. You may be something else. I appreciate your beliefs, although I don't maybe agree with them and or have different opinions, ideology, theology about some things, then that's okay. Honestly, that's okay. I'm glad you're here. I'm glad you're watching the channel. Maybe something I says triggers something in you. Hopefully it's not hatred. Hopefully it's out of love, but maybe it triggers a thought, a question. If you have those questions, comment them down below. But I just want to welcome you in. I am a Christian, but that doesn't mean we can't be friends. We can't have a community. And I just want you to know that. So thank you so much for watching. Whether you're a Christian, atheist, or anything in between, just know that you're welcome here. You're welcome with the Travis Heath Racing group. And we are so happy to have you. So one of the things that my pastor was talking about today was just kind of where we're at in this coronavirus and as a nation, as a community. And for some of you, you may not have seen any difference. And I'm so glad if you haven't. For some of you, like myself, you're a little bit more of an extrovert instead of an introvert. And you need people. You need people around you. I believe even introverts need a community and people around you. But with this, with where we're at with the pandemic, the coronavirus, and depression rates skyrocketing, suicide skyrocketing, and just as a whole, really feel like we are just lonely. And part of that is just a generational thing, but for the greater part, we've learned to grow up in community, being forced to be around people, whether that's going to school, whether that's transportation, whether that's being in a job. And this has really just thrown it off for us. And we need people in our lives to come around us, to edify us, to support us. So all that being said, he was just bringing up just kind of like how it takes numbers. And it takes people coming together, creating a team, and creating a team and just coming together and supporting each other in a time of need. And I believe that we all need that. It's really hard. It's really hard for us to do something on our own or to complete a task solely on our own. Some of us need a pep talk, need a push. Some of us need people to get out of the way, but you're still needing people, depending on your personality. So all that being said, I just encourage you to pick up your phone right now. If you have to click off this video, that's perfectly fine. The views on this video aren't worth as much as people in relationships. So I just encourage you, even if you have to come back to this, which I wouldn't mind you do, but if you don't, I completely understand. Click off of this, send someone a text saying, hi, hey, how are you doing? Checking in on you, thinking about you. You never know in that person's life what that means. You never know what your impact in that person is. And you may just be missing each other. You may not be in immediate contact with them. And you may just think, oh, well, they don't need me, you know, to do everyday life. When the reality is, and it's really probably true, is they're probably waiting for someone to message them today. So whenever you see this, if you just click off, send one, at least maybe five people, you never know what that conversation can do. And if you're feeling lonely and you need prayer, you have questions about anything of that nature, or as I said earlier, me being a Christian, whatever, comment down below. I love to have a community here. Comment down below. We can chat it up on there. And of course, there's a lot of avenues to where if you're dealing with suicide, and I will put the suicide hotline number down below. I never want to mention suicide without giving an avenue for you to call and have people there ready for you. Just know that you're loved, that you are not lonely. There are people in your life that need you, that want you, and wouldn't have the life that they have without you. So that goes for everyone. And just know you have a purpose. You have a destiny, a plan for your life. And yeah. So let's get on with this car. Enough ushy-gushy. No, I'm just kidding. I really love talking about stuff like that. And hopefully that encourages you. Hopefully you can message someone and make their day, make their week, and be that change that they may need. Moved. I have the center switch panel piece pushed back in here, so hopefully it'll just come right out. I know for sure I have not done this with the e-brake handle, which that's going to get moved and placed in a way sturdier spot, but so it should come on out. Perfect, just how we designed it, right? Oop, added to the cracks. Good thing we're fixing all those. So here is the dash out of the car. I just wanted y'all to see the severity of these cracks here. This is all from the sun. Obviously, this is probably like the worst case that I've seen. Seen a couple online, but not any in person that are this bad. Just to give you an example of how fragile it is, when I just said, oh, added to the cracks, pulling it out, I hit this on the hanger for the steering wheel, and it made a whole dent there. So we're going to end up gouging these out, using some fiberglass filler, filling it, and then recovering the whole dash. But we have that out. This is what it looks like without the dash in it. So I have a kill switch over here. I have this is a fan relay. All of the wiring right now comes into this center area. And I know, don't be disappointed with me. I believe everybody gets to this point of adding stuff over time. And as you add little by little, it's hard to go back. And you kind of just need a moment like I'm about to do, where you know everything of what you need, go back, sort it out, make sure it's all plug and play. Something I want to change is I want all the gauges to be plug and play, whether that's off the back of the gauge or that is in the actual harness of the gauges. I need to read into that, make sure that's okay. But so this is kind of what it looks like in here without a dash. We did have it to this point when we repainted it. We used this bar and just mounted the stock hanger for the steering column. And if you haven't seen this before, here's kind of a overlook. Something I want to do, I had a scary moment where I had a coolant line pop off, and it actually came through these holes right here. So I would like to fill these holes, patch them up, and everything that I'm not using on the firewall, just to make it a little bit safer, of course. And then I want to fill the holes in the back for anything, so any smoke or anything doesn't come in. If you can hear that, someone's getting it out on the freeway. We're real close to 249 toll road. But yeah, that's the inside. So next is the seats. Get those pulled out, and then we'll probably have to call it for today. Stopping point for this video. As you saw, now we have a open and clean slate per se to the interior. That way engine bay, interior are the things that I really need to address as far as suspension and drivetrain wise, what is still in the car, like the rear end axle, stuff like that. I can service, inspect, or clean those where they're at. So I'm really excited now. I have everything out and I can start modifying, cleaning, redoing, and adjusting some things that I've found that I don't like about the vehicle, and fixing stuff that is worn, broken, and whatever. But really excited to get to this point. That way I can just come in, pinpoint focus what I'm trying to do, and just start from a good state like this. So I hope this video was fun to watch, encouraging you. Make sure if you didn't, just pick up your phone, text someone, tell them, hey, FaceTime with them, message with them, call them, whatever. You never know what your relationship and your time can do and impact in people's lives. And they may be there sitting there waiting for you to message you, for you to talk to them, whatever. And just remember, a relationship goes both ways and we all need each other. So be sure to reach out if you did it and it was successful, or you have a cool story, comment down below. I wanna see that. That also encourages other people. Or, you know, message us on Instagram at Travis Heath Racing. If you have any questions or anything like that, whether it be personal, whether it be about the YouTube channel, about God or anything, you can also message on the Travis Heath Racing Instagram, and we will definitely get back to you. We'd love to hear from you. If you like this video and you want to see more or previous videos, check out these videos that are coming up. Hit that center subscribe button if you'd like to subscribe. It definitely helps us out, seeing your subscription, seeing you following along with the videos. Thank you so much, and I can't tell you that. Thank you so much. And it's because of y'all that, you know, we're getting to do this and get to take you on this journey with us. So thank you so much. We love you from the Travis Heath Racing fam. Y'all have a great day.